If you are so educated, you are very wise, then okay, you are taking only little bit, one peg. But you know, if you are somewhere very bad drinker, they just bring bottle of wine, they will not finish, they will not stop until the bottle is finished. Like, and I was reading somewhere else, if you want to save the dead bodies, you can keep the dead bodies in the wine. Just fill the wine in the tub, you can keep body, and body is saved. Body is saved. If you really want body convert into dead body, you can put wine into your mouth. So the central place of the Sikhs, this is very, very beautiful place, and it is built with the gold plates, and some people say golden temple, but it is given by the English people name, but its name is Hari Mandar. Mandar means temple, Hari means God, the temple of God. Whenever you go to India, you must try to go there, and you will really feel something good, something very divine, because there is 24 hours devotional singing going on for 500 years, 24 hours. And so many, about 300,000 people go every day, and 250,000 people are served food free of cost. Can you believe? 250,000 people are served free of cost food without any distinction, caste, creed, color, religion, vision. And it has four doors. This golden temple has four doors. It means, it symbolizes, it is open for all. Anybody can come from east, west, south, and north side. All are welcome wholeheartedly. Harimandir Sahib, golden temple, it was built in 1588 AD. This is the Sikh greetings. How do we greet? Like just I said you, good evening. We greet each other, Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh, with folded hand, like very respectfully, because we see you are also man of God. You are the creation of God. We love you and we respect you, everybody. We say we belong to God. Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa means we belong to God, and Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. Fateh means victory, achievements, what we have achieved, what do we have victories. All the victory, all the achievement also belong to God. If I am helping you, if I am sharing my things, it is not mine, it is given by God, and I am not arrogant, I am not egoistic that I am giving you. This is given by God. I am just sharing. That's why in Sikhism, there's a concept of sharing, not a concept of donation. When you are giving, oh, I am giving you donation, it means you are a giver. And someone is taking, he is like a beggar, and you are giving. Once you are sharing, like you are sharing your everything, money, food, with your children, with your family, you are not donating them, you are sharing. Yeah. And this world is our family. And when we are giving something to someone, it means we are sharing, we are not giving, we are not donating. So when you are sharing, your mind is only God is giver. We all are beggar actually. Yeah. God is greatest giver, we all are beggar. So when you are sharing, we don't consider, I am giving you, this is, I'm sharing. So. Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. And another way of greeting is also Sat Shri Akal, shortest greeting. Means Sat means eternal, true. Shri means timeless God. God is eternal. God is only eternal. We are not eternal. We are in the time. You know, the time was there, we take birth on this earth. The time will come, then we will no more here. So we are in the cycle of time. Beyond the cycle of time is only God. God does not die. God does not take birth. He is forever. The first chapter of Guru Granth Sahib describes about God. What is God? Guru Nanak says, God is one, and He created the earth, He created everything. And He is very true. He is only true. His name is true. He is creator, and He is fearless. He is without enmity feeling. He has no enemy. He is not your enemy. Sometimes, if you have hard time, we have hard time, then we say, God is my enemy now. God is not in my favor. Actually, you are not in favor of God. That's why you have hard time. God is always in your favor. Like sun is there, every day you can see, you can have very shining sun. But if you are living, if you are living in the room and all the doors are closed and you're blaming, there's no sun, no sun. Owl cannot believe sun because he cannot see sun. Some people are like owl, O-W-L, owl. They are, because they don't love, they don't chant, they don't realize, they don't try to realize God. They say, there's no God. But when you open your eyes and come out from your very small place, small-mindedness, come out, then you can see, oh my God, you are so wonderful. Your creation is so wonderful. Who created this wonderful creation? If you are not here, if God is not there. Actually, there was a boy. His father says, there's no God. Why are you worshiping God every day? Why are you chanting the name of God? He say, God has created this world, God created me, everything created by God. He say, no, it is all automatically created. Nobody has created this earth. Then he was, about 8 years boy. He just drawed very beautiful drawing and kept in the drawing room. Very beautiful scenery. And father came at the evening. He said, wow, very beautiful drawing. Who drew this? He said, Papa, I don't know. It is automatically, I don't know. It is automatically drawn. He was asking, no. Everything is created by someone. It's not right. He said, Papa, this is your answer. If small drawing, small scenery is drawn by someone, how this big scenery, bigger scenery, very beautiful scenery of the world created itself? No, someone is there who created this. So God is eternal. God is loving. Okay, article of faith. Whenever you see someone like me, you can see I have turban. And what is under my turban? There's uncut hair, knot here. You can see very big knot, uncut hair. I'm not supposed to cut my hair. And you can ask me why you don't cut your hair, why you don't trim your beard. I will ask you a question, why you trim your beard, why you cut your hair? It is given by God. If I'm loving God, He has given me, I'm loving to Him, He has given me this gift, I keep it as it is. Because I try to live according to His will. This is His will. He has not given to the women, right? So I think Jesus Christ also had a beard. I'm not sure. You are well known about it. And whenever you read, very olden books, you can see everybody has beard and turban or hair, uncut hair. Anyhow, so we have uncut hair covered with turban. This is turban and kanga. Kanga is called a small wooden comb placed within one's hair because I supposed to comb my hair morning and evening. When I'm combing my hair and some broken, dead hair comes out, and I have to learn from that there are so many dead ideas in my mind. I have to comb that dead ideas, negativity from my mind morning and evening when I am combing my hair. Kirpan, This is a ceremonial sword worn with a shoulder strap. So you can see, like, this is actually, it shows, it is not for offense. It is for defense. In olden time, in India, the ruler was Muslims, and they can kill you, they can kidnap you, and you don't have weapon, you cannot save yourself. And all the Sikhs had very big weapons, everybody has to wear. And if the Muslim invader come and invade you, attack you, the Sikhs were saving themselves and Sikhs were saving others. Sikhs were saving so many Hindus, so many people who are defenseless. So it means you have to save others, rights, others. This is my, this is our divine duty to save others too. Kada, a bracelet worn on the wrist. This is kada. And it signifies that God is like, this is in circle. God is like that. God has no starting and ending point. We have starting and ending point. Like my starting point in 8 September 1982. And I don't know when ending point will come. Maybe today, tomorrow, or I don't know. So nobody knows when ending point will come, right? But God is endless. We worship, we love that God who is endless like God. And we are not supposed to steal. We are not supposed to take others' rights because this is like if you are a thief.
Handcuff.
Sorry?
Handcuffs.
It's given by God. This is handcuffs. So don't steal others' right. Don't steal others' money. It is already handcuffed in your hands. And whenever you think, like, this is someone's things, and I'm taking and keeping in my pocket, it means this kada is going far, going back. And when you are giving, okay, I have $5, you are very needy, helpless, I'm giving you, and you are here, and my kara come forth, come here. Because when you are giving, God will be there. When you're taking others' right, God is going far from you. So next is kachara. Sorry. Soldier shorts worn as an undergarments. These are five articles of faith. So you can see my turban. Turban covers the personal and private part of the Sikh's body, uncut hair on the head. And this is the actually symbol of royalty, dignity, and leadership. This is very reverence cloth, very respective turban. If you are giving turban to someone, it means you are giving so much honor. And if you're touching my turban, if you are removing my turban, it means you are really insulting me. So if you are exchanging your turban, there are so many idioms, it means you are becoming brother, real brother, when you exchange your turban. And it is, I was watching one movie a few days back. The ladies with children were drowning in the water. They don't know how to swim. The Sikh boy was there. He had turban about 8 meters, and he also doesn't know how to swim. But he just threw his turban into the water, and he could save 4 or 5 lives with his turban. And in the war of 1971, India war with the Pakistan, with the Bangladesh, and the general was a Sikh. The general of army was a Sikh. I think his name was Jagjit Singh Arora. And when he saw so many ladies, naked ladies, in the camp of Pakistan army, and they have kept all the ladies, they were naked. They didn't have cloth. And he, you know, he was a Sikh. How he could see them, he just throw out his turban and cut into so many pieces, small pieces, and given to everybody. Please cover your private part of your body. And he thought then he gave statement, I was thinking, my guru has given me this burden on my head, about 300 or 400 grams. You know, this is a very heavy thing. And now I could realize this is not a burden. This is a honor. This is a sign of respect, sign of dignity. It is not my dignity. It covers others' dignity. It covers others' respect too. Color depends on the person's preference. There are so many colors, you can wear any kind of turban. And I know you are loving my turban too much. Because it's also a sign of love. Pink color, right? I don't know. So, a symbol of royalty, dignity, and leadership, it's about 5 to 8 meters long. 5 to 8 meters, this is 8 meter turban. And turn round the head 5 or 6 times. Light and soft, but its cushion-like appearance may give the wrong impression of its being heavy. It's not heavy at all. It's an ideal headgear for both winter and summer. And once you are wearing this turban, you no need to wear helmet. In India, you no need to wear helmet. In some other countries too, if you're wearing turban by law. This is very interesting things. We Sikhs has last name. All the women have last name Kaur, and men has last name Singh. This is very common. Whenever you see any Sikh, his last name should be Singh. And you will be wondering why. Everybody has Singh name. Every lady has last name is Kaur. Because we believe in brotherhood. We are all one. Our common father, God. So we are children of God. And our last name is also same. So we don't consider you are rich, you are poor, you are lower, you are high. We all are equal. We all have last name Singh and Kaur. In olden time, if you really belong to very, very rich family, you know, royal family, you have special last name. And if you are really belong to very poor family, then you have last name. Your last name will tell others you are belong, which family or which caste you belong. So we don't consider any caste. And this is a dress for women's. Salwar, relaxed fitting pants, kameez, long shirt that usually reaches the knees. Chunni means a rectangular piece of lightweight cloth around the shoulders to cover their head. Salwar kameez has modern and elegant look, comfortable to wear in all climates, you can see. Okay, what Guruji says about gender differences? This is very beautiful. Quotation, I would love to sing. Just one line. Guruji says, Ete aurat mardaan saaje, Ete aurat mardaan saaje, E sab roop tumhare. Oh my dear divine, oh Lord, you yourself have fashioned all these men and women. They all are your forms. They all belong to you. And the Lord himself enjoys every being. He pervades in every woman and men. This is about what is love. What is ideal couple? Love is composed of a single soul inhabiting two bodies. And Guruji says, Tan pir eh na aakhiyan, behan ikatthe hoye, ek jot doye murte, tan pir kahiye soye. means they are not said to be husband and wife who merely sit together, eat together, or sleep together. Rather, they are the true husband and wife who have one spirit in two bodies. One spirit in two bodies. Stay together, who pray together. This is the ideal family. If you pray together, then you can stay together. Then possible. Because then you have all the qualities, all the virtues in your life. And some more slides, I will talk about the values, divine value of Sikhism. You will love it. Okay. Principle of daily living. These are the very basic principle of Sikhism. Earn an honest living. Means be independent and do not beg. We are not supposed to beg. We have to work hard, work smart. And share with the less fortunate. Once you have earned good money, then you don't say, this is my money. But this is a capitalistic world. Everybody say, this is mine. This is mine, which is yours. It is also considerable. Maybe this is also mine. Mine is mine, yours also mine. But scripture says, nothing is mine, everything belongs to God. Mera mujhme kich nahi, jo kich hai so tera. And always remember God. The langar, I already have mentioned about this. The free kitchen is open to all and is prepared by the congregation and financed by their contributions. It symbolizes equality and is also a community service to ensure no one goes hungry. Dasvand. This is also one tradition started by Guruji. Suppose you earn $100, you must at least give $10 for the charity, at least. But I am very mean sometimes. We are mean. It is very hard to give. It's easy to take. We say to God, give me this, give me that. We don't say to God, we don't pray to God, please give me strength, I should give to others. Give me this strength, whatever I have, I should give to others. And these are some concepts, how should we live our life. Very beautiful, Chardi Kala. Always being in high spirit. Chardi Kala. Asikhs accept God's hukam. Hukam means the will of God. Happily, he takes life as it comes. He accepts pleasure and pains with the same spirit. Thus, he is always in a blissful state. He thinks, if I have pain, no problem. It's also a gift of God. Some kind of experience you only have when you are in pain. And who is my relative, who is my real friend, when you are in trouble. When you are happy, you have everything, then you cannot recognize, you cannot understand who is real friend. Because everybody is taking your money, everybody enjoy your things. Chardi Kala, he is never disheartened. Means you have to live in high spirit. I have not failed, what Thomson Edison said. He was in Chardi Kala, right? I have not failed. I have just found 10,000 ways that won't work. Right? So, if you have pain, okay, it's no problem. Pleasure is coming. Pleasure is coming. Still enjoy the pain too. It's very hard. But when you are receiving grace of God, loving God, then you will love it, actually. Youth is not a state of life, it is a state of mind. Young is. Sometimes we say, I'm getting old, I cannot go to church now, I cannot do, devotional things, all these, we have excuse. But if you are God-centered, God-centered, godly, then the Gurbani says, Guru says, Gurmukh budde kade nahi jina andar surt gyan. The Gurmukh, the Guru-oriented, God-centered, godly people, saintly people who are conscious within never grow old. They are always in blissful and mindful state. They remain alike in pain and pleasure. Who are godly people? A connected mind is never shaken. If we are connected to God, Gurbani says, scripture says, if the mind is not shaken, how can the body be afraid? If your mind is powerful, nobody can afraid you. You know, if your mind is very weak, even you have very healthy body, you are poor. You are in afraid. Charan kamal chit rahe samaye. My mind is always connected to the divine feet. How it can be scared or shaken? Because I live under the awe of God. Determination. Firmness, fortitude, single-mindedness, strength of mind, willpower. The mind remains steady. How? By devotional inclination to the God, to the Vaheguru, one remains steadily and does not waver. He who loses money, he loses much. He who loses a friend loses much more. But he who loses faith